So we're building a decentralized order book exchange, which will provide users with the best possible experience because prices are going to be the actual market price of the exchange. The users who are using this exchange are going to determine that. This eliminates the need for liquidity providers like in PancakeSwap, who usually just charge fees for every transaction. This requires more computing power than an average computer can provide. But with Cartesi, that problem goes away, and transactions happen much faster. We're building in Python and using SQLite as a database engine. We use it the same way on the OS as we used it in Linux. It's all familiar tooling available in the Cartesi machine. We previously developed a lot of stuff directly on the blockchain, but that requires blockchain developers. And we all know they are very hard to find. So, a major benefit of the OS is the easy onboarding of new engineers. Even without basic Web3 expertise, you can start immediately on the OS, because our DEX parts are pure Python code and need no prior expertise to set up. The whole OS experience from beginning to end is well packaged. You need to learn only a few things. Basically go through the README and create a decentralized application without diving into the EVM or Solidity. You have the HTTP API and you can just interact with that without knowing the actual blockchain stuff that's happening in the background. Basically, when you have, let's say, a market cell or something like that, it can demand a lot of processing power. And if you tried to do that in the traditional blockchain environment, you'll probably have to split this logic into smaller chunks, right? And have some logic to orchestrate and check if all the parts of the computation were correctly processed before achieving the final result. But in the Cartesi machine, you can throw this larger amount of computation and process it at once, without having to worry about a processing cap. Soon, they will make it even more scalable with the aggregator. But the whole structure of the OS, the whole architecture, is built in a way that scalability is one of the main aspects. And that's a great load off the developer's mind. They don't need to create overly complicated solutions just so that their app is scalable. We'd be very interested if we could try JavaScript and Node.js. For one, we have a lot of people who are most familiar with JavaScript. Running it on the back end is something I think we can easily do with the Cartesi machine. It would make routing easier, and it could abstract to a lot of other things. It's partially a front-end facing framework too, but we also use it a lot for the back-end parts. Our tools are set up like internal templates for Next.js projects. So for us, there's a special interest there, as we're also partners with Vercel. When it comes to hundreds of millions of dollars, you can't just trust an unregulated, centralized entity. And because crypto exchanges, apart from a few like Coinbase, are very much unregulated or in territories where the regulation makes it very difficult for US institutional investors, for example, to enter, they are not able to interact with those exchanges. They only have a few options when it comes to regulated exchanges, with Coinbase being an obvious choice. But when they want to interact with many coins, Coinbase is very limited. And all of this because of the regulated aspect. They only have a handful of coins available for trading. The rest is out of the exchange. So they have to move the money out of the exchange. But if they move it into liquidity pools, these hundreds of millions of dollars are subject to security issues and the EVM problems as well, general slowness of the blockchains and so on. So our DEX will be a place where this investor can trade and do any of the traditional things that he would normally do, thanks to the computational power of the OS. For our DEX, we want to make sure that we add as many currencies as we can. So for people who want to trade, we can fulfill much of their trading needs. I also think that from the business standpoint, there's a clear need for a decentralized or web-based exchange. Also, we want to have a pro interface for our decentralized exchange. Now, decentralized exchange UIs are just not set up for serious traders, like they would do in the New York Stock Exchange or other more mature traditional interfaces. And when it comes to the blockchain, this is the first project that has a real chance of giving that pro interface while not being centralized. Institutional players are opening to decentralized alternatives, you know. You can, of course, use things like PancakeSwap, but that has a very immature interface and it's hard for thousands of people to use and to collaborate on. That collaboration piece we can naturally build into our product. So I think there's huge potential for the business side to go forward.